So definitely, yeah, the Danes.
So our first match this morning is the compound cadet women's team gold medal final. See here already that Mexico have won the bronze medal in this division earlier in the
Ladies
week.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the athletes to the field for the compound cadets women team gold medal final.
Our athletes are now entering the field of play for this gold medal final. Only one time in this event's history has this not been won by the USA, and that is when Mexico defeated them 2 years ago in Rosario. Can they win their title back today?
Representing the United States,
but they're going to face
America,
a fierce challenge from
Reagan,
the Russians.
Bender, Faith Miller, Makenzie Weatherspoon, and their opponents on target number two, representing the Russian Federation, Arina Cherkezova, Darya Perfilyeva, Nika Snetkova. The line judge for this match is Katerina Plakuda.
So, Lena, what in this gold medal final now, what's going to be important in the first end or two for these teams?
And definitely you have to, stay
focused,
even though it's a big field. And a big competition. Get a good start, always good when you compound, because it's not like in the set, like for recurve. Every point counts.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
It does. Both teams seem to have a lot of support in the crowd. Faith Miller will be leading off the US team in this gold medal final. Do you quickly want to run us through how the team match works, please, Lena?
Okay, you shoot, how many is it?
It's 3 hours. That is how you lead your team off in a gold medal final. Take out the spider in the center of the target. These targets are 80 centimeters in size and they are 50 meters downrange. That was a yellow card there.
Oh, was it?
Yes. So, can you explain how we get a yellow card?
Oh, it's if the next archer steps over the line before the first archer has passed the line, you can get the yellow card. Then you have to drop the arrow.
Yes.
If you put it at the bow, and go back and then to the line again.
They've done it again.
Yeah, just like she's.
She's put the release on the string before she crossed the line.
Oh.
So the release aid in compound cannot be on the string before they come over.
Yeah, it
they
has have to be to put a clean bow.
Yes.
Eight.
Russia are not going to have much time to shoot their next three arrows.
No, definitely.
10.
Faith Miller is definitely dialed in here this morning.
Eight or nine on the line.
Definitely a nine.
Yeah, it was a nine.
I think very important now that the Russian coach is explaining to the three athletes to make sure they have very quick changes.
Solid start there from the USA.
This is going to be really tight.
Yeah. Puts a lot of pressure on the last archer. Oh.
No.
Oh,
she can't get it
on.
Oh,
my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, damn.
That is not the way you want to start the first end of a gold medal final.
But two yellow cards.
Yes.
That's not the. Yeah. Doesn't happen often.
And, but she was nervous trying to load the arrow.
Yeah.
I think if she had just been normal and not rushed.
As you notice, there is a time limit on the field of play. On average, the archers are getting.
The athletes only have 2 minutes to shoot their six arrows. Unfortunately, with two yellow cards.
It takes a lot of coordination. And practice with your team
that takes
sure
a lot of pressure
off
the USA in this final.
It really does.
It's never over though.
No, they can still go back from that.
The Russians need to pick themselves up and just think very carefully. They look a little bit gutted right now.
Yeah.
In the qualification round, the team from the United States ranked in fourth position with a score of 1,980 points. In the round of 1/8, they faced Hong Kong, China, where they won with a score of 226. In the quarterfinals, they faced Australia and won again with a score of 226. Going against Mexico in the semifinals, they upped their game and shot a 229, bringing them to this gold medal match.
I think it's going to be important if though America get those two asterisk arrows marked up or down, because it'll define, you know, the gap can be slightly less. All smiles on the US side, but they've still got a job to do and need to stay focused.
Yeah.
Judges are still confirming the arrow values.
And I believe that here at the World Youth Championships of 2019, we are almost on record-breaking pace for the number of athletes that have come from all around the world. And we have broken it down to these two teams.
While we've got this quick scoring delay, do you want to quickly explain the rules of the compound team again?
Okay, so 3 hours at a time. Then they change to the other team. And then 3 hours again.
Yeah.
So 6 hours in total.
And it's a total accumulative for the 24 arrow shot.
Yeah, 24 arrows.
So in recurve, that wouldn't have been the end of the world.
No, definitely, because then the other team would have just got a set point.
Yeah.
It's easier to get back from a bad round if you're on recurve.
But in compound, every arrow
counts.
Yeah, and that could be both good and bad.
Yeah. It's very unforgiving.
Yeah, it really is.
9.
Three really strong arrows there from Russia. But with a 10-point deficit,
yeah,
and 18 arrows to make that up, it's not going to be easy. And Faith Miller has shown already that she is dialed into that 10 ring.
Yeah.
Spoon as well, now finding the center of the target. The Americans looking very relaxed. Russia under time pressure again for the second end in a row. They took those changes very carefully. They're hanging a bit left with their their group. Points there for the USA, absolutely showing no mercy against the Russian team. Have you ever seen an all left-handed team before, like the US, like this?
No, I didn't even notice that.
All three are left-handed.
That's pretty impressive.
I think that could be a first.
In the qualification round, Team Russia actually scored. No.
The US only came ranked into this in fifth, I believe, and the fourth, actually, sorry. The USA were ranked fourth, the Russians were ranked third for these finals. Russia really not happy with themselves at all for that really silly mistake at the first end. And losing an arrow through getting timed out with two yellow cards.
Thank you.
Snetkova with a 10. Arrows all hanging left still from everybody.
Yeah, from everybody.
Nine.
I think Cherkezova needs to use this as an opportunity now to get herself ready for the match she's in later on today.
Yeah, definitely.
She's shooting for the gold later today, and
nine.
She just gets to learn a bit about the range now.
Yeah.
She's got to take something away from this, because if she hangs on to it, they all look really down, the Russians. The Americans under a bit of time pressure here, I think.
Ten. Eight.
Couple of loose arrows from America.
Nine. Unofficially, Team USA with 55 points in that end, and Team Russia with 57. And as you can see, Team USA has an asterisk beside their third arrow.
I think that'd be a nine.
That arrow could be an eight or a nine. And in this case,
but we'll wait for the judge to decide.
Between two scoring zones, the archer will get the higher score for that arrow. So it turns out to be a small inspection by the target judge to determine whether that arrow was in or out. And USA gets the upgrade on that arrow. It's called a nine, it's called in. Going into the final six arrows, USA leading over Russia, and Team Russia will be shooting first on target number two.
Final end of this match coming up. USA still with that 10-point lead that they got off end number one due to Russia losing an arrow through time. This really is a case of the USA just making sure all their arrows make it to the target. They look very relaxed.
8.
Russia have not got going. I do feel if they'd really piled in the tens, they could have got USA worried reduced the deficit quite a bit.
Yeah, definitely. But getting two yellow cards must have made him pretty nervous.
No.
Yeah. Just get this over with, shooting. Well, very loose arrows there from both teams. Final arrows from the 10 from Russia. But again, they find themselves under time pressure.
It's 10, 10, 10.
Great
perfect
finish.
Score.
Nine, 20 points required from the USA to win the title. So 5 points required from Raegan Bender to win the title back for the USA that they've only ever lost once.
10.
Brilliant 10 to finish there.
And ladies and gentlemen, your champions for the compound cadet women's team is the team from the United States of America. Congratulations, USA. Congratulations.
Unofficially, we have to wait for judges' confirmation. The USA win the gold medal here at the 2019 World Youth Championships in Madrid in the compound cadet women. Russia never recovered from their fatal error on the first end. Lena, what did you think?
I thought was some strong shots from Russia, even though they lost the arrow. I know it takes a lot of energy to pull back from that.
Yes.
Definitely. I've tried it myself, losing an arrow in a match, shooting in the different in another target.
Yep.
It's the worst. So being able to pull back from that in a gold final, that's